Hi, this is Jill, and I'm going to do a really quick demo of how you might use alligator clips with your reed switches, just to kind of test things. So, if you don't have a battery holder, you can use conductive fabric tape to kind of make one. So I'll show you a trick. I put a piece of conductive tape on the top side, the top positive side of the battery, and then I put another piece on the negative, bumpy, bottom side. But what I'm doing is I am going to put a little piece of insulating tape around the edge of the battery because I don't want the negative piece of circuit tape to accidentally touch the side of my battery when I'm prototyping because the edge of the battery is positive. So I have a piece of negative circuit tape touching the negative side of the battery and a piece of positive circuit tape touching the positive side of the battery. Then I'm going to use a blue alligator clip. I'm using blue because we use blue to symbolize the negative trace. I'm going to connect the blue alligator clip to the circuit tape that's touching the negative side of the battery. Next, I'm going to connect the reed switch, and it doesn't really matter which end you use because switches don't have polarity. Then I'm going to take the red alligator clip and connect it to the positive trace, which is touching the positive side of the battery. And then I'll take a third alligator clip and clip it to the free end of the reed switch. Next, I'm going to connect the little light, and I know that this is the negative side of the battery. I'm going to connect the LED. This is an LED that doesn't have any adhesive on the back that I use for prototyping. And then we'll bring over the positive alligator clip to the positive side of the LED. Just make sure that when you do that, that you don't touch the metal clip to the little resistor. You just want it to attach to the little metal pad. Alright, so now this is an incomplete circuit because the reed switch is currently open. To close the switch, to close the circuit, we need to add a magnet. And this one's a really little tiny one. Now I'm going to test each side of the reed switch by placing the flat side of the magnet on the center part of one edge of the reed switch to see where the magnet wants to be. So I kind of fiddle around with each side to see which sides are most likely to light up the LED. The side that I end up picking happens to have two little recessed circles on it. There was only one edge of the reed switch that didn't seem to want to work, so I had three good sides that I could choose from. I ended up picking the one with the two little recessed circles as a visual cue. In the event that the side of the reed switch that you've chosen doesn't have recess circles or some kind of visual cue to help you keep track of it, it's good practice to leave the magnet in place when you remove the alligator clips from the reed switch. Then, it's a good practice to curl the legs of the reed switch carefully. The reason that I do this is so that I can get more circuit tape in contact with the metal of the legs and with the paper to help the reed switch stay down better. This prototyping method is useful because it can make working with reed switches a little less fiddly than putting something into a project and then finding out that you have to take it all apart.